what is the best way to teach engagement?
Become valuable to your dog. We're actually going to do videos on that this week. So how do you teach engagement? Well, we find by just doing stuff with your dog, holding your dog accountable, being value, don't let other people pet your dog, don't have your dog go up to other people, work your dog. Believe it or not, holding your dog accountable builds engagement.
Sure does.
Like, we see it all the time. Next. Going live. Now we're live. And we're live. Hey, everybody. How are you? Happy Saturday night. It's Jeff. It's Jeff and Joelle. Here we are with the What Would Jeff Do show. If you're brand new to our show, it's a 90-minute podcast. We do this three times a week, every Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. Saturday, historically, at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 90 minutes. The questions come in, and the answers go out fast. Ideally, in a perfect world, we would have a lot more time to answer the questions, but we're actually going to be redoing our whole Patreon channel that we'll be able to do that. But these questions are really, really quick. Theoretically, everybody needs a board and train to ask a question. But boy, a lot of people get huge value from the show. Now,
did you post a link up?
Yes,
today?
I did. Sure did. Early this morning or this afternoon, I did. Yep.
I can't find it.
It's there. It's definitely there. W passed it. Also, we do something called Jeff Gellman Seminars. Go to Jeff Gellman Seminars, Jeff Gellman Seminars. And what you'll find there is that there are 2 days. We're doing 28 cities, 7 countries. If you have to go to YouTube Live, just go to YouTube. Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't find
it.
Shit. Oh, well. Oh. You're going to learn.
Just keep talking.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. So this is the Joelle Show. And then what we're doing is at our training center, which is everything we do here. So the seminars and the podcast, we talk a lot about punishment, how to properly apply a punisher. Punisher is not a bad word. It's the only way to stop unwanted behavior. But at the training center, we're about 95% reward. We're actually food trainers. But we also stop unwanted behaviors. So here we go. Joelle. Oh, wait, hold on. One more thing. There's a little dollar sign in the corner. You know, if you click on the dollar sign, it's something called Top Chat. And you, your question goes to the top of the queue. We answer that, but you do not have to pay to play. Next.
Gretchen, hi guys. Can't stay now, but I might be able to come back later. I took my little brother out for dinner after he took quite an emotional beating today. I'll come back when we're done.
Sounds good, Gretchen. Gretchen, also thank you for the gift. I got it today. Thank you.
Melissa, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and everyone in the chat.
Hey, thanks. Melissa. Did you get Britt's question? The first one?
Britt saying, hello, I have a question. Can I clicker train my German Shepherd without treats because she won't eat them? She's 3. She's doing so good on walks. I'm loving the walks. She was being a smart butt today, downing inside instead of backing up.
Clicker is just a marker. It doesn't mean food is following. It means a reward is following. So it can be physical touch, or it can just be a marker. You don't even have to use a clicker. Just use the word yes if you choose to. So that's up to you. Next.
Jamie, hello from Washington. It's 30 degrees and we're supposed to get up to 10 inches of snow this weekend. How are y'all doing?
You're the one living in Washington. It was 65 degrees here, which is unusually warm in Providence.
Yeah, that's warm.
So we have winters too. We have 4 seasons as well. So we get dumped. We can have winters here where we get, you know, 50 inches of snow over the course of the winter, 100 inches of snow over the course of the winter. It's been a while for that. We've also had winters here where it's just cold and no snow. Next.
Gretchen said, also, Joelle, you look pretty tonight.
She looks beautiful. Stunning.
Thanks, Gretchen.
Yep. Thanks, Gretchen.
Britt, I'm really happy with training my German Shepherd. She's making me look great.
Awesome. It's not about making you look great. Just be happy with the journey. Be happy with the journey. Next.
Michelle, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, Melissa, fellow fans.
Hey, Melissa, how are you?
Michelle.
Oh, hey, Michelle, how are you? I heard the word Melissa in there.
She said good evening.
Oh,
Melissa.
She said hello to Melissa. Oh, I thought that was like Melissa's token hello to everybody.
No.
Okay, got it.
Rashna, hi, my dog gets aggressive with strangers and his food lately. He's 100% okay with myself and my husband while he's eating, but acts aggressive if someone else walks near him while he's eating. What would Jeff do?
Number one, a couple of things. Number one, I would teach your dog the out command. Number two, I'd feed your dog in a kennel. Number three, why are people walking by your dog when it's eating? But still, that's not going to stop the problem. Teach out to back away. But to me, I like to, you know, first let's fix the problem, but for all practical purposes, feed your dog in a kennel, My dog's eaten 30 seconds or less. Actually, I freeze her. I feed raw. So actually, I do meal prep and I freeze it and I actually give them this big lump of like frozen food.
Takes a little bit longer.
Takes a little bit longer. Also works their teeth. It works their teeth. So next.
Jenny, good evening, Jeff and Joelle. I've started bonking my dog, but I found that he'll turn around ready to bite at times. Is bonking not a good tool for him?
I don't know how you're bonking. We're not seeing that. So are you saying the word no and then bonk? Now, we don't. Once you bonk a dog once or twice, you're not usually having to bonk it. So, like, you might be doing it wrong. So, bonking dogs does not make them aggressive. Fact. How do I know? I'm the guy that's bonked over 10,000 times. That's how I know. And I'm not seeing dogs become aggressive. And I work with aggressive dogs. I'm seeing dogs become non-aggressive. We are stopping aggression. So, you could be doing it wrong. You know, trust me, I've seen a lot of people do it wrong. Next.
Milligan Valley Canine Academy. Hey guys, hope you're doing well. Looking forward to seeing this year in Canton again. Joelle, I really enjoyed your Facebook Live this week about IG stories. Great advice we plan on implementing. Thanks, guys.
Awesome, definitely. And Joelle will be doing another tip of the week. And also, don't forget, we do social media. We do social media Skypes. Joelle does social media Skypes as well. And you can go to our website for that and sign up. And that applies for every business. It's not dog training. Next.
Cheryl. Hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, how are you, Cheryl? Cheryl.
Top Gun dog training, stopping by to give thanks, continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory. Grateful.
Awesome. Thank you, Top Gun.
Josue, love the Angelo painting.
Thank you. Thank you.
Skincare queen, does neutering help with separation anxiety and unwanted behavior? Of course, with punishment and proper training.
I've never seen, let me just clarify here. Every single dog, almost 100% of dogs, that's a lot of fucking dogs over 15 years, as well as at seminars around the world. I have never seen the de-sexing of a dog stop an unwanted behavior. That doesn't mean I'm for or against it, but all I'm saying is that's not going to stop anything but procreation. Next.
Melissa posted the link to your seminar locations.
Awesome. Thank you.
Mr. Crazy Milo, so how did this all start? How did you learn to train dogs?
15 years ago, I had a badly behaved dog. Somebody helped me rehab that dog, and then a lot of trial and error and working with tons of dogs. I have actually didn't go to school for it, and people love to use that against me, but it's like I've met people that have gone to dog training school that couldn't actually even walk a dog properly. So, I mean, come on. Let's go. Big deal. So massive amounts of dogs. I've worked with close to 10,000 dogs. So I'm also an avid learner. But I just love how people love to throw out. For the last 15 years, how I didn't get any formal education.
Yeah.
It's like there's actually something called sweat equity, which is actually more valuable historically than formal education when it comes to dog training. And also, it's not rocket science.
Yeah.
Like, I'm a pet dog trainer. Like, my career is new. Like, nobody needed a pet dog trainer 20 years ago because your parents probably just stopped unwanted behaviors in any way they could. Up until the 60s and 70s, when they all of a sudden started, you know, doing a marine animal training. They wanted to make it look like it was some scientifically highly learned thing, and it's actually not. Now, is there a proper way to do it and an improper way to do it? Depends what you're trying to either train or stop. Yeah. What are the most effective protocols to train a behavior? What are the most effective protocols to stop an unwanted behavior? Sure. But they don't teach punishment that much, which is what we do a lot of because that's why dogs are dying. Next.
Michelle. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Joelle, you've been rocking social media. I'm really jazzed to follow the new Blue Merle Border Collie's progress.
Yes.
He's doing great.
Yep. So we're going to do a whole thing on, what's that dog's name?
Hugo.
Hugo. Because a lot of people seem to have dogs like that. That's because a lot of dogs are like that. And believe it or not, that's a simple dog. That will be a simple dog. That doesn't mean, when I say simple, that doesn't mean easy for the staff. They're still going to be putting in hundreds and hundreds of hours of training into that dog. over 6 weeks. But what I mean by that is all of you could do this with your own dogs. Like all that lunging and barking could be stopped in about 3 seconds, which doesn't fix the problem. Training still has to happen, but a lot of that stuff can be stopped. Next.
$10 top chat from Travis.
Hey, thanks, Travis.
More pug stuff. Pug is panic barking when walking away from placing him in the back seat of the car since he hit 6 months. Wasn't an issue before. Any thoughts to fix this?
Walking away from?
See, so that, if the dog is in the car and they're walking away,
oh,
and
yeah,
he starts panic barking.
Yeah, so don't say panic barking. Just say barking. Okay? Get a remote collar and tell the dog to shut up. You won't mess up the dog. All right? Next.
Britt only did a 40-minute walk, LOL, and yesterday took a break. It was nice.
Good. Yeah. You can take a 5-minute walk. I didn't walk my dogs at all today. I haven't walked my dogs for a long time. Ran them in the woods.
Yeah.
That'll be, if you put a compilation together, that'll be nice for that.
Maddie's working.
I was going to say, or just send it away, please, to somebody. Good.
Jasmine corrected my dog for staring at another dog. She cried out. I felt bad. But later, when we had to walk past that dog, she did amazing, as if the dog wasn't even there.
Why are people feeling bad about correcting their dogs? Do you know that if I have to clean out one of my dog's ears, they whine?
Oh, yeah.
It's like, but when you correct them, you feel bad. Like, take your dog to the vet. That's when you see fear.
Yeah.
So it's like, why are we feeling bad for stopping an unwanted behavior? You know, you should feel bad for your dog either like getting on the counter ingesting something and dying, or paying for a huge emergency room bill, or not stopping unwanted behavior and you have to put down your dog or surrender it. Mm-hmm. Or living in a really small world with your dog.
Yeah.
Guys, it's like a lot of this stuff is one and done. Or one and done and then little reminders. But it's like, if you're not prepared to correct your dog, don't get a dog. Don't.
It's like part of the deal.
I can't answer emails anymore, you know, individually. I have to do a cut and paste response because we get so many and we offer so much free stuff. But it's like, someone's like, my 6-month-old dog has started growling at me. What do I do? I've been told it'll grow out of it. And I'm like, no, it won't. It'll grow into it. Mm-hmm. You correct it. How do you correct it? I'll let you come up with a lot of ways, but there's a lot of ways to stop a growling dog. Mm-hmm. All I know is this: if I owned a 6-month-old dog and it started growling at me, it would know that growling at me is bad. And this is what fucks up people. They yell, they scream, they shake their thing, they do time out.
Yeah.
They get emotional. No.
Bad dog go in the crate.
Yeah, it's like, no, that doesn't work. No. What do you do? Believe it or not, bonk. If you don't want to bonk or is, look it up, please. It's a towel. All right? No, bonk. Guess what? No more growling. What do you keep looking at over there?
Nothing.
Oh, I thought you were like, look, there's something on the wall. Or someone's looking in the window or something.
No. What the hell?
Next. You're getting me paranoid. Too much coffee. Next.
Clearly. I'm just trying to like look at you.
You looked like you were looking
I'm
behind
looking
me.
At you.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Oh, I swear to God, it looks like you're looking behind me.
God. All right, Josue, can't wait to finally attend a seminar. Holy shit, Josue, you're coming to a seminar?
That'd be awesome.
We get to meet you? Wow. I have to, like, make a picture in my mind of what I
it's
think
it's so
looks
funny.
Like.
It's so funny. We meet so many people at seminars, and we,
and
like...
And they put their real name, though.
And we're like,
who are you?
But I'm sure you put Josue, but, like, there's screen names.
Yes.
And, like, and we don't even know, like, we...
Like, wait, Marnie Cool Dog? We didn't even know that was her, I don't
think. I know.
Like,
no,
heck,
because
Marnie?
A lot of people don't have their they've got like, so Marnie's got a lot of horse pictures on her thing.
Yeah.
And some people on their Instagrams have got like just non-human pictures of themselves.
Yeah.
Which is fine. But I'm just like, it's like we interact with you every week and we finally meet you, but we don't really know, oh, you're
and
that
who,
person.
Who is it we met in Vegas? Fucking Rye Bread. I'm like, holy shit, it's Rye Bread.
That's right.
Oh, so cool.
There's going to be some great seminars this year.
Yeah.
Yeah. Florida's coming up. The next one's coming up is in Florida, by the way. So Pearson, Florida. So it's the only one I'm doing in Florida this year. Drive, guys. It's no big deal.
Florida's not that big.
No. Next.
CPK9. Hi, you guys. How do I win over a me, the trainer? Reactive, freaked out,
Huh? Decipher that shit.
This is how it's written.
Oh, yeah.
How do I win over a me, in quotations, the trainer? Reactive, freaked out, rescue terrier. 5 years, 13 pounds.
Okay. What's the question? How do I... What's the first part again?
How do I win over...
What do you mean win over? What is win... What is
a reactive, freaked out rescue terrier.
You're not trying to win anybody over. Like, what do you mean? How do you... What skill set do you need? You don't want to win over that dog at all. What you want to do is do... Just do our training. Do basic training. Start with this. Massive structure. You're not trying to win over. You're not trying to be friends with this dog. You don't need to build a relationship yet. Or I shouldn't say this. The work will build the relationship. The training will build the relationship. Number one, you're reactive. Cut that shit. That could be done easily. Leash pop, bark, remote collar. Stop being reactive. But number two is massive structure. Train it on obedience. That's not going to stop reactivity, but it's like, and then train the dog. Lots of structure. Cut down on affection. A lot of these little dogs, everyone's carrying them around. Stop carrying them around. Crate them up. Next.
Chloe and Luca. Hey, guys. Jeff, my boyfriend says you sound like Vince Vaughn.
Okay. Cool.
Vince Vaughn. You kind of do. All
right.
Skincare queen. Sorry. I'm not touching anything.
What?
I saw you get paranoid when I kicked the bucket.
You kicked the bucket? What are you talking about?
Because you're scared of this light.
I've got to get a new light.
So I kicked the bucket and you were like, like immediately, like you're going to make a light go off.
I was just wondering what was down there.
I was waiting for you to say it. Like, don't.
Is this pick on Jeff night?
No.
Or it sure seems like it.
I'm reading your cues.
It sure seems like it.
You went from that to.
Okay. Do me a favor, don't kick the bucket on the show. Because that's not going to make it for a good show.
Kick in the bucket. Done. Skincare queen. Should you always follow through with bonking? For example, I go over to my dog to bonk a bad behavior and they stop. Do I still bonk or let it go?
Okay. Let me explain how to apply a proper punisher. There's something called markers. You've got a yes and a no. Those are the big ones. Yes is I like what you did and something usually good is going to follow. No is I don't like what you just did and something negative is going to follow. As soon as that dog does the unwanted behavior, you say no. Then you can walk over to your dog and bonk. Next.
Romeo, awesome show, guys. Love your content and advice.
Thank you. Thank you for being here, Romeo.
Chloe and Luca.
Sorry about Juliet. Don't worry. It wasn't going to work out anyway.
Mm-mm.
Going to work out.
Doing from the start.
No. Start from scratch. Okay? Find a new castle. Next.
Chloe and Luca, what is the best way to teach engagement?
Become valuable to your dog. We're actually going to do videos on that this week. So how do you teach engagement? Well, we find by just doing stuff with your dog, holding your dog accountable, being value, don't let other people pet your dog, don't have your dog go up to other people, work your dog, believe it or not, holding your dog accountable builds engagement.
Sure does.
Like, we see it all the time. Next.
Michelle, in Chicago, it's doing this stupid thunder, snow, ice, NATO bullshit.
Shut.
No walks today. This weather hurts me.
Yeah, you gotta watch out for that stuff. You have to watch out for that stuff. Next.
What's that noise? Lindsay, hey guys, thought I squashed issues with breaking out of the crate with a board and train, but after a few hours, the dog freaked and tried to break out again. How do you stop the breakouts if they seem random? Double down is default when in the crate now, but after a few hours in there alone, she pops up, tries to break out.
If you set up a nanny cam, use a remote collar, make it suck to break out of a crate. Next.
Karen, practicing sit-stay at the park on a ledge or small platform, but can't get him to look relaxed and calm. He stays, but jerks his head around all the time, checking everything out on alert.
Have you practiced it in a non-high-level distraction area? Have you practiced it in a non-high-level distraction area? So first you want to do that. But second of all, you want to build up duration on your sits in low distraction areas. Start adding environmentals inside. Bring your dog outside. Do it in a low distraction area outside. Start adding environmentals outside. And then you'll start seeing better progress. Next.
Chloe and Luca, what is the out command? Leave it?
We don't use the word leave it. Out we use for a lot of things. Watch our stories from today.
Out with Marlo.
So out is a couple of things. Out means I use out for my dogs to spit out the ball. They do it by default, actually. You know, I play chuck it. They bring the ball back. They spit it in front of me. Joel's dogs do it too. But out means puh, spit out the ball. Let go of the tug. Let go of the arm sleeve. Let go of the human you're biting for protection work. But we also use out for a couple of things. It means get out of here. Literally, I'm sitting here eating a sandwich. The dog comes up to me. I say out. The dog moves away. It's very, very common for two humans, they can't hug because the dog also wants to get in there too. You can say out to get the dog away. So out means to disengage. Next.
One big weirdo. My rat terrier has recently started obsessively licking everything. How do I stop this?
Do a health check first. Check sodium levels, but also any OCD behaviors. A remote collar to make it suck to do that can stop that. But do vet check first. Next.
Erica, hey from Virginia. We have a 3-year-old rescue with leash reactivity. E-collar work in progress on a walk. Is there a difference between correcting while walking or stopping, let them walk by and correct?
Okay, so a couple of things. Number one, you have a dog, not a rescue dog. Rescue is not a breed. It's really important that we specify that because a lot of people are using that as an excuse. You're not, but it's like you own a dog. Like, this is my adopted son. This is my natural birth son. No, like, this is my dog. At one point, I owned 12 dogs. I got one of them from a breeder, the other 11 I acquired, and they were all dogs. So it's just important because it's a psychological thing that we're talking about here. So number one, I'm a big fan of in motion, but you try both. Try both. So you're only correcting, though, the unwanted behavior, and you're correcting the thought of the unwanted behavior, which is the loading. That's what a lot of people are missing. Next.
Canadian girl. My male dog refuses to go potty where he always has gone. He marks 17 months, so he goes back in the crate. He will go on deck or in our house, so I put him in the crate. Any suggestions? I keep taking him out, too.
So that's disgusting. He goes in the crate and in the house. So number one, slip lead out, go to the potty spot, go potty, stand there. Don't move. When he goes to the bathroom, make sure he fully empties his bladder. Click, reward, come back in. Next.
Jamie, I emailed your front desk about a prong collar I got from you earlier this week, but I haven't gotten a response. Tried to use the contact on your website as well, but no luck. Should I email again?
We respond to everybody very quickly. Like, really, really quickly. In fact, the front desk email is empty because I just checked it tonight. So there's no emails in there at all. So email us again. Email us again. But, yeah, next.
Skincare queen, my dog is very scared and sensitive to a lot of things. We are saying no calmly when bonking, not doing it super hard, but he is shaking and visibly scared. Should we continue?
Well, I need way, stop the bonking. Number one, we don't bonk for being afraid. You can correct, but so stop that. Number one, I need a lot more information. A lot more information. Like, what's the dog doing with that fear? If it's just shaking, there's ways to do duration work and process it. But also, sometimes you want to be in movement. So I need to know what you're actually doing. I'm not going to just blanketly give you an answer. Next.
Karen, nice wall behind you.
Thank you.
It looks very crooked.
Yep. I'm crooked on purpose just to piss off all the OCD people.
Especially and, me. Looking at the screen. And
you can fix it if you want afterwards. Okay? Next.
Tanya, dog barks while we are gone. Do you have a bark collar you would recommend?
We like the Garmin Bark Limiter and then also E-Collar Technologies. Next.
Michelle, so my mom had questions about the bonker. She assumed that my dogs are scared of it. I said no, then I threw the bonker and played with my dogs with it. Once they got too excited, I said no, grabbed my other bonker, and all three dogs disengaged and went down. It's not the bonker, it's the cue.
It's the no, right. And guess what? Hey, mom, remember when you were raising me? Didn't you want to use a little bit of fear to correct, change my behavior? I hope you did, mom. Didn't you? Do you remember that? Did it work? Did you turn out to be a good human being? Were you a good kid? Was your mom able to change your behavior? Or did she bribe you with 20s and 50s if you didn't do something? Or did the spoon, soap, twitch, hand come out? Punishment is very important. The big thing with punishment is you're not using emotion. If I can stress that so much, You're not yelling. I mean, I'm going to start saying this all the time so people really get it. You're not yelling. You're not screaming. You're not upset. You're not emotional. It's matter of fact, no, and then consequence. And you have, there's timing is important. What you do after can be important. There's so many variables there that are important. So why do we talk about punishment so much? Because you could, because nobody else is talking about it. Nobody. I shouldn't say nobody, but like not many people are. They're all afraid to. Everybody's afraid to talk about. It's so funny. The number one reason why dogs are turned into shelters and put down is because of unwanted behaviors. The only way to stop an unwanted behavior is through the application of punishment. Meanwhile, nobody wants to talk about it. The number one thing killing dogs, nobody wants to talk about.
Right.
But they all want to save the dogs, but they don't want to talk about how you actually do it. Mm-hmm. If anything, they'll do it the opposite way, and they'll say, make sure you find a positive-only trainer, which can't stop an unwanted behavior. It's been proven over and over and over again. And meanwhile, we clicker-train dogs here. But that's not how we stop an unwanted behavior. Step one, stop the behavior. Now we can do some training. Next.
Yep. Saki, how do you stop the dog biting the leash when the prong collar is on?
Oh, that's just an objection. Just say no, and you can bonk it. Say no, and use a pet convincer, which is compressed air. Don't tug on it because the dog thinks it's tug of war. It's not the prong collar. Dogs do that with slip leads, flat buckle collars, martingales, harnesses. They do it with every collar. Everybody assumes that it's because the prong collar hurts. That's a lie. Next.
Dark Warrior, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Dark Warrior.
Free content. I really hope you can do a seminar in Phoenix this year.
Find me a place in Phoenix. We can do a seminar in Phoenix in December or November. There's dates. We have one date left, two dates left. Next. But I'm going to be in Ramona. Hold on. Sorry. I'm going to be in Ramona, California. That's a done deal. I'm going to be in Las Vegas, Nevada. That's a done deal. And they're both very drivable from Phoenix. Why? Because we're driving through Phoenix. Next.
Lisa, I am having some success with walking my ACDs with the e-collars, but one is so anxious that another dog passing us or barking, he redirects to my other dog. Today it was an all... God, where's the rest?
Mm-hmm. So number one, there's an art to remote collar healing. I would make sure you at a minimum have prong collars on your dogs. Also work them on separate sides of you. Also the one that redirects muzzle up, and then correct that dog for doing that. Next.
Jamie, do you have any favorite breeds of dog to own? I'm partial to pitties and Dobermans.
Nope. Whatever I like doesn't matter. Whatever you like is all that matters. Next.
Cheryl, oh my God, I'm so glad to hear you talk about how you started in dog training. I also didn't go to school, and frankly, I can handle a badly behaved dog way better than so many certified trainers.
Yeah, certified trainer doesn't mean shit. It doesn't. And that's all they're hanging their hat on. There's something called sweat equity, and I can't stress it enough. It's so funny when you go to some people's dog trainers' websites, they list every single fucking seminar they've ever been to.
I know.
Every fucking school, everything. It's like, okay, that's really cool. And they got all this stuff. That's really cool. Where's the videos of you working fucking dogs? Oh, I'm too busy to take a video. No, you're just a lazy fucker. Take out your goddamn phone, put it on a tripod.
I did that today because nobody was around. I'm like, I guess I'll record myself working this dog.
And you're not trying to prove a point. You're trying to help people. You think I do this show to fucking get business? No. We spend $100,000 a year on putting out free content, not to get new business, to keep dogs alive. Do I get new business from it? Sure, I'm sure I do. But the ROI on it, sure, the hell ain't all that great of a deal, I'll tell you that much. Next.
Chloe and Luca, do you keep your dogs in a kennel in the car? Worried my GSC doesn't have any protection in an accident.
Nope, I don't. And people are going to always give me shit about that. It's like, if I get into a bad car accident with my dogs, I know that it's going to suck for them. Is that irresponsible of me? Is it irresponsible of you not to train your dog recall and have it off leash? To me, that's more dangerous. Okay, what's the number of dogs that are hit? Okay, what is the number of dogs that are hit by cars and die compared to the number of dogs that are in car accidents and die?
I'd be afraid of the crate like crumbling in.
Right. Well, there's only maybe two.
Yeah, like impact and stuff.
That have been crash tested.
Right.
But your dog, more dogs die. More dogs die probably from counter surfing than car accidents. True. More here. Let's keep going down the road here. More dogs die from not stopping unwanted behaviors than car accidents.
Probably. Yeah. I'm sure there's a statistic.
Yes.
Out there.
What I'm saying is, like, more dogs are dying in our shelter system because nobody could stop their bad behavior, and the chance of getting in a car accident with your dog is, I'm sure the number is out there, but it's, I assure you, it's no match for not training your dog.
Agreed.
Next.
Gina, we went to the vet this week, and for the first time in 2.5 months, Max got on the scale, sat nicely, and nice. Got checked with no outward signs of anxiety.
Beautiful.
I could have cried.
Good. I mean, not good that you could have cried. Yeah, fuck it. Good that you could have cried. I cry all the time. This is the thing.
This is the thing.
Tex could give a flying fuck about the vet.
He's really good there. When I took him the other day, I just put him in a sit-stay on the chair.
It's like, with Tex, I'm like, he doesn't even need, like, he had to have some incisions done. And they're like, oh, we have to give him a little bit of painkillers. I'm like, don't give him fucking painkillers. He doesn't care.
He really doesn't.
He doesn't care. He doesn't. He's a Malinois. He doesn't care. Trust me. Fucking dog will fucking run into a tree and keep going. Mm-hmm. Kira doesn't mind. Girl hates the vet. And guess what? I take her there once every couple years. What do I care?
Yeah.
It's no big deal. She hates it. My outdoor dog, Mac, he's not the biggest fan of the vet.
Yeah.
He's not the biggest fan of the vet. But again, it's not like I take him there that much. The behavior of the dog at the vet, first of all, I'm not discounting the progress you're making at all. So, but I'm just saying, though, but a lot of people are like, my dog is great, but it growled at the vet. Okay. Does it growl at anybody else? No. Literally. It doesn't growl at dogs? Nope. Doesn't growl at people walking by on the street? Nope. Somebody comes to your house and gives you a hug, doesn't growl? Nope. You take it to the vet, it growls? Yep. How often do you go to the vet? Once every couple of years. Who gives a shit? Next.
Next. Travis, perfect. Thanks, guys.
You're welcome.
Mr. Crazy Milo, when can you tell if a dog is ready to stay home alone out in a crate? Is there an age or behavior to look for?
No.
Out of a crate.
I am a fan of crating dogs when nobody's home, so I'm the wrong guy to ask. Another trainer will tell you, okay, a trainer that believes that a dog should be out of a crate eventually will do it. And I can't tell you how many people will fucking bash me for everything I do, but for literally like he's got to crate his dogs at night or when he leaves.
And
like, Jesus Christ, what's the big fucking deal? I'm not willing to risk the life of my dogs.
Yeah.
And the destruction of my home.
Also, Kira knows how to deploy out of windows.
Yeah.
God forbid.
Yeah.
She smashed through a
window. Literally, one of my dogs is trained to jump through windows and jump out of windows. That's all I need her to do is to be fucking jumping out of a window. She once tried to deploy out of the front windshield of my car, my RV, smashing it. But meanwhile, she can jump in through the side windows. FYI, Kira, when they're fucking open.
She's like, yeah, whatever.
She's like, I don't care.
Kira doesn't give a shit.
She doesn't care at all. That's why it's like bonking. Oh, my God. It causes brain damage and brain trauma. My dog fucking put her head through a goddamn fucking windshield. Yeah. And guess what? Didn't blink an eye.
No.
It's so funny.
My guys have slammed right into it. Like, today they did. They just, like, smash into each other.
And when they're doing play? Oh, my God.
They don't care.
All the time.
They just don't care.
All the time.
$4.99 top chat from Michelle.
Thanks, Michelle.
Glad you mentioned the car thing. I tend to worry about everything. Was going to get a harness buckle thing. You're right. Bigger things to worry about.
Listen. I'm not going to say not to get a harness buckle thing. That's not what I'm saying. You do what you're comfortable with. But all I'm saying is it's called choice. Unless they make it a law that your dog has to be, which would be ridiculous for people, because sometimes it's impractical.
Dog has to be a seatbelt. I would never. Like, I'm sorry. Wes, on my seats?
Well, first of all,
no.
The hell if you want your dogs in the second row.
I
don't want my dogs to be seatbelted in, because that means they've got to be in either the front seat or the second row of seats. Fuck that. My dogs are in the fucking I got an SUV. They're in the fucking cargo area.
Yeah, the way back.
They're in the way back.
Where the rubber lining is.
That's right. And today, when I took all the dogs across the street to play Chuck It, I had 5 dogs in the back of the SUV.
Everybody get buckled in.
No. But again, guys, we've got clients that seatbelt their dogs in. That's fine. Keep doing it. They put a blanket down. Yeah. They do that. They put the harness on. They buckle them in. Keep doing it. Absolutely. I don't want to dissuade anybody from doing that. But all I'm saying is it's like I weigh choices. So I feed my dogs raw. You know, has it been proven yet? It will eventually come out. Feeding raw is better. Now, who's to say that? Oh, who are you to say that? Da, 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 da. Well, sorry, but Nestle, I ain't going to fucking believe what you say. Purina, no. Science diet? Oh, because you got science in the name? That doesn't mean you know your fucking shit. Next.
I'm going to readjust this thing. Here we go. Mr. Crazy Milo, training credentials are nice, but the proof is in the pudding. Your methods have clearly helped a lot of dog owners.
Yeah, credentials. I'm not going to discount credentials, but it's like, okay, if I go to a brain surgeon, I'm going to want to know that you like know what you're doing. Like, not through trial and error, hopefully. But for dog training, I also want to know what you're doing, but also I can't stress sweat equity has value. Also, have you worked? Okay. If I was going to do agility with one of my dogs, and my path was I want to compete, I would absolutely want to know that somebody that I was hiring has a history of getting dogs up to competition level and placing. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. If I want to do agility for fun, what do I care if you've gotten a dog up to competition level?
Right.
For a pet dog trainer, can you stop stuff and teach stuff? Yes, I can. Great. You got videos? 25,000 of them. Great.
Yeah.
That's it.
Also,
dog training is 30 to 40% dog, 60 to 70% human. Mm-hmm. So you better be a good human trainer. Dog trainers, the thing about the dog training industry is this. They only focus on the dog. They're literally forgetting the most important factor, the actual owner.
Yeah.
The owner, the human. That's the biggest thing. And you're going to see a shitload of videos in 2020 of us. I mean, I've been doing this for 15 years talking about human training, but we're going to be going overboard with human training. By the way, did I mention this? Did I do that on stories? Did I mention we're looking for another social media intern?
Yep.
I mentioned on this. I'll mention it again.
No, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Okay, we're looking for another social media intern. Our social media intern that we hired actually is turning into a paid employee. We're looking for another intern. Also, we actually, if somebody wanted to live on property with free rent, you want a lifestyle change? You can do some film editing. You got some skill sets. Okay, you want to fucking work here? Guess what? Apply. Next.
Yeah. Britt, does age matter with clicker training?
No. Well, if they're dead. But then that's...
That's not age.
That's not age.
That's life.
That's dead.
That's dead.
No. I imagine a one-day-old dog doesn't give a shit about the clicker. Next. Yeah.
What are you going to do?
Yeah.
Click. Here's the T.
Yeah, but you could...
Click. T.
You actually could do that.
Yes.
You could.
But they're like deaf, aren't they? Don't they come out like deaf anyway?
This is all I know is this. You can teach a 12 or 13-year-old dog what a clicker is. Next.
Adam, got a 2-year-old Doberman. He was dog aggressive prior to dog training. Now he's way more dog aggressive, and now he is redirecting at me.
Okay, I don't know how you trained him. I got no idea. You know? What kind of dog training did you do? Did you do dog training that stops an unwanted behavior? Not the tools you used, but the philosophy. And then also, what's your lifestyle with this dog? Do you hold the dog accountable? Are you underwhelming your dog? There's a lot of variables in there. Can every dog be rehabbed? No. Does everybody dog deserve a chance? If they can. But also, if you started rehabbing the dog at 16 months old and now it's 2 years old and it got more aggressive, it might have just been age. It was on the trajectory to become more aggressive because now it's a full mature adult. But what kind of training did you do? Did the dog learn that biting another human or dog is a bad thing in a way that the dog understands? We're not seeing dogs get worse. So, next.
KK, can a fearful, nervous dog ever be happy to see visitors eventually?
Happy, define happy. Can a fearful, nervous dog ever learn to exist around visitors? Absolutely, positively, we do it every day. Mm-hmm. Happy? What's happy for a dog? Next.
$10 top chat from Best Behaved Pups, Karen. FYI, the two of you are my credentials. Jeez. LOL. Also, I tell everyone that I train the owners. The dogs are easy. True story.
Do me a favor. Who's that?
Karen.
Karen, don't be throwing my name around as credentials. I'll tell you that much. All right? So, I don't seem to be a very popular person these days.
Chloe and Luca, someone told me to low-level shock for my leash reactive dog glancing, not staring at another dog while he's in a heel. I understand staring, but glancing? Thoughts?
Intent. Intent. Understand what intent is. Is that, who's that, Chloe?
Yeah. Chloe. In the beginning, we don't let them look at dogs.
Yeah. So there's a couple of different theories you can use. Total avoidance, right? Like, mind your business. Or all depends on the severity of the leash reactivity or the aggression. But at the beginning, like Joelle says, it's like at the beginning, you can take it all away. You can take it all away. But now you've got two different opinions. Which one are you going to follow? That's the problem. So you can try both. Try both. See which one works. Do A-B testing. Next.
Josue, another one before then without the dogs. Oh, so he's going to do two seminars?
Nice.
Cool. Ms. His. Hello, guys. Jeff definitely sounds like Vince Vaughn. Never thought about it.
Okay.
Do you know who Vince Vaughn even is?
He's an actor, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's a huge actor.
Okay.
You do sound like him.
Okay.
Who thought? Like, I've known you for how long? I've never thought that. But now you do. You sound just like him.
Okay.
Ro, I used to roll toilet paper.
Vince, do me a favor. The fucking Jeff Gellman impression, it's getting old.
You guys have, like, the same stupid humor, too. Ro, I used to roll of paper towels as a bonker. It worked. My dog was a little freaked out, but she lived and the behavior stopped.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Really? The dog lived. Really.
It worked?
Really. The dog lived through having a roll of paper towels thrown at it. Surprise, surprise.
Wow.
Yeah. Pretty funny how that works.
The sky didn't fall.
Yeah. It's funny. Somebody made a comment on YouTube that says, one of Jeff's haters made a 42-minute video about how bonking is terrible. And literally, he's like, worked for me, and it seems to be working for tens of thousands of other people. So, it's so funny.
So weird, right?
It's so weird that people that actually are doing it properly are getting the great results, but other people are, like, thinking that it's the worst thing in the world. Especially the people that are using remote cowers at high levels that think it's the worst thing in the world.
Yeah.
It's like, that blows my mind. That I'm blown away at that. But you know what, though? Here, this is the thing. 8 years ago, duration place, I got ripped apart for.
I'm sure you did.
Ripped apart. Oh, my God, dogs in place. Who would ever do that? Huh. Seems to be quite popular right now.
Quite popular.
Sitting in chairs. A year ago, we started doing that. Oh, my God, that's so stupid. Interesting how we're seeing a lot of fucking photos and videos from a lot of trainers out there. Doing sitting in chairs now. Interesting, isn't it?
Sure, was born here.
Okay. So it's just really, really funny. It's really, really funny. Bonking? Huh. Nobody wanted to talk about it except for my buddy Gary. And now I'm talking about it loud and clear. And meanwhile, dog trainers hate it. Why? It's too easy and you can't make money from it. You know who likes it? Dog owners. Mm-hmm. I mean, I can buy a towel for $1.32 from Walmart, number 64 rubber bands, roll up the fucking towel, I got a free video on that, say no calmly, throw it at my dog and it'll stop a bad behavior such as barking at the front door, loading up at a dog. Yep, you can do that. Yep, sure can. Whining in the crate. Yep. Holy shit. Do you mean I don't got to pay anybody any money? Nope. Dog trainers hate that. Yep. That's why. That's why.
Yeah.
You know?
Simple.
Simple. Effective.
Owners can do it too.
Right. Yeah. So, trainers, you gotta up your game. Make yourself valuable as a trainer so people still want to hire you. Because it ain't rocket science to fucking train a dog.
I had to go home today. And he even admitted, he's like, I've always been so soft on this dog.
Yes, I
like,
know. Great couple, by the way.
First thing I had him do, he's whining in the crate. I'm like, you gotta stop your dog.
Yep, I know.
So he takes him out and he's like, he actually had really good aim. Like his timing and everything was good. And he's like, wow, really effective.
Yeah.
I know.
That was such a great couple.
They're awesome.
They're really great.
Yep.
I'm really proud of them. They'll be back tomorrow too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did it awesome.
You know what? We've got the greatest fans in the world.
Yeah.
And the people that are able to economically afford us, whether it's a seminar or one-on-one or board and train, are some of the nicest fucking people you'll ever meet.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
And for people out there to, like, shame them and to make it look like they're fucking idiots, it's like, you guys have no fucking clue.
Mm-hmm.
The amount of anger that's out there, the amount of anger that is out there right now that people have, really, people should be working on that.
Yeah.
They really should.
If everyone did a little bit more work on themselves.
Or just a little bit of personal
growth.
Man. A little bit of personal growth.
The world would be a different place.
I gave out someone, it was a private conversation with Tang.
Yeah.
I can't reveal it. Damn it. Tomorrow, I'm almost out of frame.
I know, and we're like getting way off topic. I feel like it's already almost 9:00.
I don't care. Okay. It's my fucking show. It's free.
It's Jeff's fucking show.
Too tough shit, okay?
Yes, Jeff's show.
Okay. So, Bronwyn, I'm doing an interview with Bronwyn tomorrow.
You're gonna?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, just like you've been here now and just your whole, what's going on with you and where do you want to go and yada, yada, yada. You'll do an exit interview with Tang, how his week has been. Because you'll do it. I think he'll be more comfortable with you and you can talk about like the full spectrum of everything. Like, you know, because we, him and I, had private consults.
I know. I still got to talk to him about his social media and stuff too.
Yeah. Yeah. So that'll be good. Nice.
Lisa, my ACDs are doing much better with walking without reactivity when I take them one at a time. But it's still awful when I take them all three together.
Right.
One reacts, one redirects.
Yep.
It's awful. What do I do?
So the one with the muzzle, first of all, make sure that they're all in the right state of mind before you start to walk. Literally, no joke here. Go to the front door. Everybody, boom, gets corrected. Huh? What? Why the fuck would you do that? Why? Because one redirects and one's reactive, and your walk is a shit show.
Mm.
So right from the beginning, you're going to go, cut the shit out. Then you're going to go like this. You're going to walk down your driveway. Halfway down, boom. Make a quick turnaround, head back to your house. Everybody, if they don't fucking follow you, they get corrected just organically. Boom. What the hell? What's her name, Lisa?
Mm-hmm.
Where the hell did Lisa go? I'm heading back to the house. I don't know where you guys are going, but I'm going back to the house. All of a sudden, walk back to the house. Boom! Turn around and go the other way. What the hell is going on here? All of a sudden, come to a stop. You guys know auto-sit. Didn't auto-sit. Correct. You guys know down, right? Down. Boom. They're like, what happened to the walk? What happened to this walk we go on? Like, hold on here. We're not going off property?
It's not a shit show today.
It's like, I got people and dogs to bark at.
Not today.
It's like, for 1 week, don't get off your driveway. Literally, up and down, right, left, turn into the dog, turn away from the dog, come to a stop, pop them in a sit, throw them into a down. Mess with them, catch them off guard. They'll be like, what the fuck is going on with this damn walk?
We need to make a damn spatial pressure video already.
Week two, guess what? Let's go for the walk. They'll be like, man, after a week of that shit, the fuck if I'm going to redirect at all ever again.
Mm-hmm.
And muzzle up the dog that redirects. Man, that dog that redirects, that's all arousal.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Read that one, the Riot Act, in dog training terms. Next.
Read them the Riot Act. Atmospheric. Hey, J&J.
Hello.
You're so weird tonight. You're sitting with, like, perfect posture, and you're just like... Like, who sits like that? I'm all, like, slumped over. That's why my back always hurts. I try to sit in the most comfortable position possible, but... Anyway, atmospheric. Hey, J&J, today I was walking my dog, and another man was walking his Springer Spaniel. My dog was getting aroused, so I did the 180 very firmly. Nice. After I did this, she sat down next to me and focused while I was having a short conversation with him. I'm so proud of myself, and I cannot thank you enough. Right. I even suggested watching your channel since he was talking about his struggles.
Okay, who's that?
Atmospheric.
So atmospheric. Okay, everybody, listen to that question, that statement again from atmospheric. That's how you become valuable to your dog. Mm-hmm. What's the 180? He's referring to the video on my YouTube channel, the 180. Not just turning 180. We're talking about a real 180. You want to become valuable to your dog? That's how you become valuable to your dog. That's one of the many ways. That's one of the many ways. So, next.
A. Bridges. Started correcting my dog this week. Whenever he starts growling, I say no, wait a beat, then correct. The first time I did it, he jumped and yelped and started shaking. Oh, well. Is it too high?
Would you use a remote collar? Has the dog stopped the unwanted behavior? That's all that matters. Next.
Conrad. When the dog is in a sit stay and a long distance recall and breaks stay before it is called, when do you apply the remote correction? As soon as it breaks the sit?
Technically, you would say no and then correct, but the dog should be on a tie back or you need a second handler. Because historically what happens is if you haven't done it from, okay, first you have to do that for a close proximity. And I would do that on a tie back. The dog needs to understand what the correction was for and then what to default back to. Or else it's going to just run to you because it's going to think it's supposed to recall to you. So take the finished product and break it down into the smallest segments. Realize that each thing is a segment. The sit is a segment. The stay is a segment, which is the default sit, by the way. Breaking it, but then when you say no, does the dog understand when you say no and apply a punisher, it's supposed to go back into a sit? Does it understand that? And the best way to do that is start with just leash in the hand and just go through the protocol before you, and then you can start 5 feet, 10 feet, 15 feet away. Next.
Gina, we're getting ready to move, and the next month is going to be crazy. Other than keeping the same schedule as normal, how do I keep Max from going back in our progress?
You said the magic word, keeping the schedule the same. That's it right there. Teach duration place. Also, when you get to your new home, the dog doesn't need a fucking real estate tour. The house is already bought. Next.
$5 talk chat from... Karen. No, I love you, Karen. The two of you. My business is booming, so using as my credentials can't be bad. I make a bonker for every client, cements them in.
Nice. Thank you so much, Karen. Love you.
Andy. Hello. Just wondering if your guys' own personal dogs ever break commands or try to break commands sometimes.
Of course.
Yeah.
Guys, yes. They're dogs.
And they usually don't have equipment on either.
Yes, absolutely. For any dog trainer to say their dog is perfect, they're full of shit. Okay, how about this? Guys, ready? Go on to YouTube right now and type in obedience trial fuck-ups.
Oh, it's so funny. I love those videos.
Okay? People that literally got a dog, specifically most likely, especially bred, to compete. Thousands of hours of training. And guess what? They still fucked up. They're called dogs. Look at us as human beings. Look at us. Drinking and drugs and arresting and arguments and like weight gain and bad diet and speeding and the list goes on and on and on. And we're talking about an animal here. So do my dogs... If I'm out of the office for any period of time, I close my dogs in a crate. Why? Because if I don't, they'll probably get into a trash can possibly, or they might like walk around and get on a piece of furniture. Do they know they're not supposed to? Of course they know they're not supposed to. But I do training with them, but I also do a little bit of management with them. And I love how someone's going to take this fucking clip right now and fucking turn this against me.
Yeah.
They will. They'll fucking take this clip out and they'll fucking write this whole little thing. Jeff's dogs can't even hold a command. Mm-hmm. It's like, yep, that's what if that's what you want to turn it into, you turn it into.
Yep.
And keep looking like a fucking dick. It's like...
They're called opportunists.
Yes.
And the couch is going to supersede the floor
yes.
any day.
It's like people... it's like, yes, it's like, so today we did an off-leash hike. We said, here, all the dogs came running back to us. Tex came running back to us, and 10 feet away, he decided to stop and smell something.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's like big deal.
Yeah.
Who cares? Like, we're not like, they're not perfect. My dogs are far from perfect. But meanwhile, guess what? I went on the road with them for 4 months in my RV, and they were off leash 95% of the time. So it's like, it's pretty fucking cool. It's pretty cool.
That's what I want a dog for. I don't care about flashy. It's like, I want to freaking take you places.
Yeah.
World is our dog park.
Yep. Yeah. Next. Did you do that $10 top
No, I think it just came in. $10 from Crystal. Last show, I asked about bonking and training a 6-week-old puppy. Just had my fostering privileges revoked because someone considered it abuse. I have the best record with placing behaved dogs. It's bullshit.
Your fostering privileges revoked because they considered abuse. So looks like you're going to be looking for a new place that actually appreciates you a little bit more. And they can find some other fucking person to fucking work with those dogs. Good luck. And when they ask you to come back, you can say, fuck you. Fuck you. Because you weren't fucking there for me. I have moved on. The best thing you ever did was to fucking fire me. Because now I work with someone who actually appreciates the fucking hard work I put in. But it's like, there's so many people. I know a bunch of rescues. And I cannot tell you how many fucking people. It's so hard to find a good foster.
Mm-hmm.
It is so hard to find a good foster. You know, and finding a foster that knows how to stop unwanted behaviors is really hard. Because when you own a rescue and you get a call at 2 o'clock in the morning saying that the dog that you just dropped off this afternoon keeps breaking out of the crate and I'm bringing him back now. Like, holy shit. Yep. So their loss. Next.
Pack leader dog training. Hello. Training a pup on basic commands since 8 weeks. She is 16 weeks old now. When can I start correcting for obedience?
After 300 to 500 reps. But 300 to 500 reps. So you might have done it by now. But does the dog also know it, though? So we don't correct for obedience until the dog absolutely knows it, until we put the reps in. Next.
Dakota and Blessing. Have you seen a dog, aggressive dog, make a complete 180?
God, yeah.
All the time.
Sure. We've also seen them not. Yeah.
We have one right now. Thor's with us for dog aggression. I'm putting up a video tomorrow of him playing in social.
Yeah. We do all the time. All the time we see dogs. I've owned dogs that literally have gone from human and dog aggression to not, and they live till 12. One of them went 9 years without being aggressive. And then I've also owned dogs that I couldn't make safe enough. Yep.
Wes has made a complete 180.
Yeah. Yeah, think about Wes.
Meh.
Yeah. Yep, he used to get into dog fights, go after every dog. We stopped that. Now he's not just tolerable. He likes dogs. Like, literally, he would see a dog and want to attack it. And now, like, not just my dogs, but other dogs fucking body slam him on the way to, like, chasing something. And he doesn't miss a beat.
He'll stop and sniff once in a while.
Yeah.
Hey, it's a dog.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, but absolutely. Absolutely. But do we have dogs that we cannot get to a level of expectation that we feel is safe enough? Absolutely. But then again, we also sometimes need more time. Mm-hmm. And owners don't either have, and I do a shitload of pro bono stuff. But it's like, also dogs don't want to keep their dog here for 6 months.
Right.
But some dogs need dramatic, intensive rehab.
Yep.
Next.
Mm, K Kaylee J. Holy shit.
Holy shit, Kaylee J.
Hey, Jeff and Joelle. It's been a while since I've been on. Just finished watching. My God, just finished working my first session with my third board and train. Mm. Wow.
Kaylee J., when did you start training dogs?
I don't know. A year ago when she was last on the show. No, she told us she was going to start.
That's right. That's right. Holy shit, Kaylee J. Congratulations. I'm proud of you. My God. Where did we see her last?
Wisconsin. Daycare.
Did we really?
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, my God. I keep yawning. Karen, what do you do for fear if no bonking?
Tons of things.
Yeah, we don't really usually bonk fear.
We don't bonk fear. We bonk. We don't bonk for fear. We bonk to stop an unwanted behavior, but not fear. Like the it's more of an active thing or for loading. For fear, we do tons of confidence building exercise. We hold the dog. We do hold the dog accountable for a behavior. But when you have a fearful dog, you work the dog. Work the dog, confidence building stuff. So, but I need more information. Just throwing out, what do you do for a fearful dog? It's like, I need to know what the dog is doing. That's why we offer Skype sessions. So for anybody that really wants to go into deep detail and to really commit to rehabbing their dog, a Skype session is what's going to do it. I mean, obviously a boarding train is what's going to do it, but some people are not, you know, they're not close to us. But people drive, like people have, they drive down from Canada to bring their dogs to us. Texas, we had a dog flying from California. But what I'm saying is it's like, I need more information, a lot more information. I'm not going to just tell somebody to bonk their fearful dog. Next.
$9.99 top chat from Ashley. Thanks for being you and showing us all we can do. Had my first client cry. It was a beautiful moment. Would have hugged her, but her human aggressive dog was there. LOL, she is now on a mission and pumped.
Awesome. So, guess what? You're going to teach that human aggressive dog the out command. And in the third session, you're going to hug that client. And you're going to say, and the client's going to say out to the dog. And the dog's going to fucking move away. All right? Just no tongue, Ashley. Next.
No tongue. Britt says you guys are the best.
Thank you, Britt.
Dark Warrior, I will definitely make an effort to a seminar this year. Thanks.
Yeah, come on, Dark Warrior.
RJ, living in Vegas, moving to a new home and looking for a dog.
Cool. So there's lots of dogs in Vegas that need homes. There's lots of homes in Vegas, that's for sure. The market there is slowly changing. And there's so many dogs that need homes there. So, next.
CPK9 said, Vegas, when please?
I think it's October.
No, it's May.
Oh, May this year? No. I don't know. No. Let's stop guessing. Jeff?
I know it's May.
JeffGellmanSeminars.com. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. Next.
Michelle, if you go on Craigslist for rehoming dogs, it's always, need to go to a home that can give more attention. I feel like those people are screaming, I don't know what to do. I'm at my wit's end.
Why are you looking at those ads?
I don't
understand. Why are you beating yourself up? Get off that. Get off that list. Stop looking at those ads. Stop. Next.
Ms. His, you put out free content so that struggling dog owners like me can be successful. Frig all Jeff haters.
You can say fuck on my show.
Frig them. That's what my mom used to say.
Did she really?
Frig them. Frig. Friggin.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I mean, she'd drop F-bombs, but
right.
She'd say friggin' a lot.
Even now?
Now I feel like she doesn't swear a lot. She's really? So different. She's, like, really different.
Really?
I feel like she's gotten, like, softer. She cries all the time now. I'm like, who are you? You give her a card and she cries. I'm like, who are you?
I cry when I get cards.
My mom was, like, stone cold growing up.
Most. Is that where you got it from? Is that where it came from?
Maybe.
Probably. Yeah.
But now she's just like this sensitive soul. It's
you'd
so cute.
Make, you, you're very like, you'd make a good assassin. You don't give a shit.
Shh. Don't let the people know.
Next.
Chloe and Luca, how do you know if you're ready to go off leash the majority of the time? He's off leash in a field and recall is spot on, but I'm nervous.
Yeah, well, the nervousness is good. That's healthy. It's like having a little bit of fear is good. Fear keeps you alive. Fear is a survival instinct, in my opinion. You know, how do you know? Do you ever know? Do you ever know? I mean, we were talking about this morning about like when we had to running our dogs off leash, and we'll make a video of that, and someone will say, what would happen if someone will like...
It's always a what if.
On the weekends, we run our dogs off leash historically because the gym doesn't open up till 7. So what we'll do is we'll meet, sometimes we'll meet here, but a lot of times we'll meet like at the off leash area that's close by. Usually the power lines. We'd love to run the power lines because the power lines are great because power lines, power lines.
Technically, it's trespassing. So you're not going to worry about other people being there.
But the great thing about power lines is it's the closest thing to fucking wilderness in a city.
Yeah.
And it's also long paths. And I'm sure someone's going to say, what would happen if they saw another dog? Like, and I'm saying, like, I don't know, I guess. It's like, but what I like to say is, or what if, they're saying almost in a negative, and I'm like, what happens if we're driving home and get hit by a fucking 18-wheeler? Mm-hmm. Like anything could happen, guys. There's so many what ifs in life. And I think a lot of what ifs keep people from moving forward.
True that.
And we're not talking about dogs here.
No.
Guys, if you haven't picked up on this show yet, this show ain't about dogs, okay? So
it's not.
It's like so many what ifs that keep people. That's the conversation I had with Tang today. I won't get into details, but he's our shadow student from Singapore. And we do a shadow program here. I think we've got about 8 or 9 of them lined up right now. We have the next year of interns lined up. And it's full immersion. It's a really, really great program. And it's a lot of personal growth involved in that. But a lot of it's like what ifs. And I think so many what ifs keep people back. You know, what if? That was Bronwyn. Yeah, oh. So she's doing last call. It's time. It's like, what if? You're right. What if what? What if anything can happen?
Anything.
You know, none of us might. Somebody out there, a good amount of people out there aren't going to wake up tomorrow.
You know, another thing is like a lot of people, and I saw this, I think, on like a meme, but it's like a lot of people are like, oh, what if it goes wrong? It's like, but what if it goes right?
What if it
Nobody
goes
Nobody thinks that way.
But what if it goes right?
Right. Nobody thinks that way.
You're right. What if it goes wrong? Oh, well.
Yeah. But what if it goes right? Pretty cool way to flip your thinking, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's what I always say.
You're
like,
choking on it now.
I'm choking on them fucking words. Because it's such a great mindset to have. It's like, first of all, if it goes wrong, that's great information to have. Mm-hmm. Well, that didn't work.
Right.
Keep trying another way.
Yep. Figure it out.
But there's no, everyone wants a guarantee. There are no guarantees other than you're going to fucking die one day.
So true.
Next.
Woo! Love it. Chloe and Luca, I already read that. Tim, in a rescue shelter? What?
You're in a rescue shelter? Well, hopefully they didn't throw away the key. Next.
RJ said, seems there are many scams with the dog adoption.
I'll leave that one alone. Next.
Raven, thank you for helping all of us dog owners.
No, you're welcome. It's my pleasure.
I really think I'm dyslexic. I mix up words a lot.
I don't think you're dyslexic.
I think you're just tired.
I think you're tired. I think you're just really tired. You're actually well read and well spoken. I think you're just really tired.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Erica, do you have any videos about being able to trim my dog's nails? Who will not let anyone hold his paw long enough?
You know what? We probably do, but I would look at the I would snoop around grooming Facebook or grooming YouTube channels. Snoop around grooming YouTube channels next.
Raven, I already read that. Erica, do you have any videos about being able... Oh my God, I'm sorry, guys.
That's not a dyslexic issue, by the way.
Celine, I have 3 months old now puppy. She freaks out when I leave her in the crate. Barks, shakes, sweats.
She doesn't sweat.
Dogs don't sweat.
I
was scared to get kicked out of my apartment, but I'm using a bonker and it's starting to work.
Yes.
So happy I found your channel this week. I've been so stressed till now.
Yeah, so make sure you say no and then bonk. You can also say no, grab the crate, shake the crate. Say no, take your hand, hit the top of the crate. And you know what you can hear people say? Don't do that. You'll create a negative association with a crate. And you know what my response is? News alert. The dog already has a negative association with a crate. You're not fucking making it. For some weird reason, all we ever see is dogs shut up. Next.
Precious Tranquility. Welcome, Celine. Found a good place. Jeff will relieve that stress.
Yes.
Jamie.
And not with a happy ending. Next.
Joelle, have you
had to... Well, from $5 top chat, I will.
Are you done? Sorry. Stop nexting me and then coming back with like corny dad jokes.
Sorry.
Any more?
No, that's it.
Okay. Jamie.
Well, I got one more dad joke I can do. So this little boy, he's in the woods with his dad, and they see two dogs fucking. And the little boy says, "Daddy, daddy, daddy, what are those dogs doing?" And the dad looks to the little boy and says, "They're making puppies." And later that night, the dad walks in. I mean, the little boy wakes up from he was having a bad dream, and he wakes up and goes into his parents' room, and he opens up his parents' door, and his parents were having sex. And he goes, "Daddy, daddy, daddy, what are you doing to mommy?" And he goes, "We're making babies." He goes, "Turn mommy over. I want a puppy."
Sick. $4.99 top chat. John, woke up from the nap. Glad to see I didn't miss the show. Dog is starting to mumble a woof when doorbell rings. Never did that before. Had a nip in the bud.
Time no and then bonk. Yeah, don't let that get out of hand. Next.
Jamie, Joelle, have you had to work with Wes on his PTSD? Just curious how you would go about dealing with a dog who gets anxious with loud talking and hand movements.
So if anybody isn't familiar with that, Joelle's ex would argue. Well, actually, let me full clarify. Joelle would argue.
Why are we just putting this all out there?
Joelle would argue. They both argued a lot. And Wes, because I'm answering the question, and so people don't have something. PTSD from what? From the war, right? So what happens is Wes would get very protective over you and get nervous. He actually didn't like it. And not, you know, dogs, like, imagine a couple arguing and yelling. And then imagine, like, divorce, you know, and if you can't, and 50% of us know what that is. So what happens is when we've talked loud on the show here, Wes actually will like get up and like
weird, yeah.
Get nervous about it. And it's like, he's having these like, oh my God, like, even though we're not married nor anything, it's us
or
talking
arguing,
loud.
Yeah.
It's like, we're not even arguing. We're just like talking loud and with our hands. You're Italian, I'm Jewish, you know? So it's like, what do you expect? Mm. You know? So, surprised we don't have a little buffet with tuna fish sandwiches and pasta fagioli sitting here, you know? So, you know, so, and so what does she do is she just tells him to cut the shit. Literally cut the shit. Guys, have that, even though that's not an official dog training term, cut the shit is a great theory to have when it comes to dogs. Just literally cut the shit. Yeah, it's as simple as that.
I think that's a cue to Wes now. He like knows. Instead of no, it's like cut the shit.
I tell my
like,
dogs to cut the shit all the time.
All the time.
Yes. That, and I tell Tex, who's my Malinois.
There he is now. Cut the shit.
Yep. I tell him. Wrong dog.
Oh, shit. It was Burke. Burke, what a place. Wes is sleeping.
Do dog trainers ever hit the remote on the wrong dog?
Yep.
They sure do.
It was on like a 4.
Doesn't matter. I've done it many times. That's why I don't like 2-dog remotes.
He didn't even wake up.
I know. He doesn't give a shit.
Let's see. Be heel dog training.
He's like, yeah, I felt that, but I wasn't doing anything wrong.
No, it was Burton.
I know.
Burton broke place. Yes, Kira putting her head through the windshield. I was at that seminar. Love you guys. Charlotte,
yeah.
I'll say hi too.
Yep.
That's crazy.
Who's that?
Be Heel Dog Training.
Oh, yes. Hey, how are you, honey?
Gretchen.
Did she say Charlotte said hi?
Charlotte and Owen. She had the other
baby. I know, that's right. Charlotte, your mama can probably play the replay if you're not watching this. Charlotte, how are you, honey? You might not remember me. You're the cutest thing in the world, and I love hearing about you, and I love hearing about all your chickens, okay? And I hope everything's going well with you and your mom, and Owen, too. You're a big sister now, all right? Next.
Did I read Gretchen's? Now I'm, like, scared that I'm reading all these the same. She said she's back. Gretchen's back.
No. Welcome back.
Seraphim Skincare. Hi, great job.
Thank you.
Cheryl, dogs are easy to train. Humans are much harder. Dogs learn to listen. Humans, not always.
So you have, so Cheryl, number one, master your human training. Listen, take 100% responsibility. So what happens with a lot of dog trainers is they blame the human, but that's the job. That's the job. Or become a dog trainer only and don't own a dog training business. So What I mean by that is only work with dogs and don't work with humans. But if you want to own a dog training business, you're going to be working with lots of humans. So you have to master the art of communicating with humans and in a way that they will learn. So you have to understand human psychology, human learning theory, human emotion. You've got to deal with like different learning styles. You know, some people are visual learners. Some people will do better with reading. But you have to, and when I say dumb it down, that doesn't mean you're working with dumb clients, but you've got to dumb it down. They don't want to know the art of dog training like you do historically. They just want to know how to stop stuff and train stuff. And they want to know how to reinforce the stuff that you've already taught. Next.
Tim, do you train dog handlers?
God, yeah. Pet dog handlers? What's a dog handler? What's your definition of a dog handler? We train humans. Yes. We also train dogs, but we also train humans. Absolutely. Ton. Next.
Yeah, like dog walker, kennel workers.
Yeah, I can. Sure. I mean, that's what I've got a staff. Yeah. I tour the country. I get hired as a consultant to go into companies. Yes.
KK, in response to the nervous, fearful dog being happy question, happy meaning can she ever wag her tail and want to come up to people?
So, yes, that could happen, but a wagging tail doesn't mean happy. Going out to somebody could precede a bite. Can your dog be less stressed and not freaked out in a people-populated situation? Yes, it can. Next. But hold on one second, though. I'm sorry to keep nexting and then interrupting you.
It's constant.
I know. It's a problem, okay? It's a problem I have because I just want to give out as much information as possible. I don't let my dogs just randomly go up to people. That's not the end goal. The end goal is I want my dogs to exist around people. Next.
Kyle, hey guys, having a discussion with a friend about sizing of prong collars. What is the common size for German Shepherd? Mine is a 3.2, I think.
Get to 3 millimeter. We don't use anything above a 3 millimeter. Next.
Delana, hey J&J, plan on having a seminar in Vancouver anytime in the future. I would love to attend with my friends and our reactive dogs.
So Vancouver, you're talking in Vancouver, Washington or Vancouver, BC? We're looking for a location in Vancouver, BC. Next.
KK, can I bonk a fearful, nervous dog when it growls at my husband?
Okay. Get rid of fearful and get rid of nervous. Okay? Got that? The question is, can I bonk a dog when it growls at my husband? Now. Okay. So now we've got a behavior that we don't want. But what's this? Now, here I am. I know I'm ripping apart all this. This is how everybody thinks I just fucking go up and correct dogs. It's the farthest thing from that. There's an art to it. And I only correct a dog if it's going to help. What's the husband doing? If the husband's just walking by and the dog growls, that's a bonkable offense. If the husband is putting unwanted pressure on the dog, which theoretically walking up to it to say hello, your family pet shouldn't be doing that. But if it's a brand new dog, it's not unusual. So historically, a dog that growls at a family member can be bonked. Can be corrected, can have a punisher applied to it for the unwanted behavior, yes. The fearful, the nervous, so many people will think that because a dog is fearful and nervous gets a free pass. No, it doesn't. Next.
Sorry, trying to find my
face. I talk for a
while. Kaylee J, I've heard some dog trainers say that place duration work kills drive. My dog does place for a couple hours at a time. I have no problem with his drive.
So those trainers, you know, whoever they are, I don't want to know names. They might be good at what they do. They might be knowledgeable at what they do. Unfortunately, number one, they're wrong because we're not seeing that. And I'll give you the best example. I own, personally, 3 high-drive, working-line dogs that spend 4 hours at a time in place because they come to work with me. So first thing in the morning, after I get back from the gym and I get Angelo ready for work, I load my dogs up in my truck and I run my dogs. Then we come to the office usually by 7:30, 7:45. My dogs are in my office till noon, in place, doing nothing but sleeping. Then we go out and play chuck it again. Then they come back in for another 4 hours. That means they've done a total of 8 hours of place. Let's say at 6 p.m., we had a bite work class. We don't do bite work here. We're actually looking for a decoy without an attitude that actually can do bite work. If I did bite work with my dogs, their drive would be just as high as if it was any other time. And I don't do sport. That's not my realm. A decent sport dog trainer should be able to actually increase drive, if that's such a thing, meaning bite harder, hold longer. There's genetics in place, but all I'm saying is when I used to do triathlons, like there's something called downtime. Like I wasn't always training. Anybody that's a high performance person usually needs downtime. But this concept of telling a dog to go to place and chill out and do nothing. So what should the dog be doing? So let's see. Let's think of an alternative here.
The kennel.
The dog shouldn't be in place for 4 hours. What should it do? Let's see. I don't want to kill my dog's drive. I think I'll let it walk around my house. Okay. So you're trying to tell me that your dog walking around your house for 4 hours is going to keep its drive intact, but having it in command for 4 hours, resting, sleeping, ignoring the world is going to kill its drive. I never heard, like, it's the most ridiculous fucking thing in the world. No, they're wrong. It's wrong. But I hear that all the time. And again, it's like, no, they're not connected. They're absolutely not connected. Next.
Kara, I have our three dogs kenneled in the same room. One dog gets aroused when I walk in the room. I bonk the crate. After I say no, the other dogs bark and growl. Should I not bonk with an audience?
Wait, what kind of audience?
The other two dogs. They bark and growl when one gets bonked. Like she throws the bonker at one crate.
Do you say no first and yes. Then bonk? Okay, then bonk those two as well. Everybody gets bonked.
You get a bonker.
You get a bonker.
Mr. Crazy Milo, how many people do you have training dogs in Rhode Island while you're traveling?
I've got four trainers at my training facility. When we travel, we have three trainers. So I don't train dogs at the facility. I don't train dogs. I haven't trained a dog here for years. So I run the company. I run a bunch of companies. I started this company 15 years ago, but now I've got a full staff, and they train the dogs. I've got a kennel staff. I've got a training staff. I've got a social media staff, and I'm running the company, which is a 80 to 100 hour a week job right now for me, because then I also have other businesses. So I'm not actually training dogs, but I did a one-on-one the other day. Mm-hmm. You can still hire me for a one-on-one. You know, so next.
Sid, hi J&J, walked my GSD on trail off leash. We saw a deer off to the side. I said no. A few minutes later, a herd of 15.
Wow.
Came on the trail 20 feet away. She looked at them, then me, stayed with me and watched.
Beautiful. Who's that?
Sid.
Sid? CYD Sid? Mm-hmm. Nice job, Sid. Next.
Tim, hey Jeff, once a dog is aggressive toward dogs and cats but good with kids and people, can you stop it from being aggressive toward dogs?
Yeah.
At 7 years old in a shelter environment, or is she too old?
In a shelter environment? Mm-hmm. No. No, it's got to come out of the shelter. Have it come out of the shelter. In the shelter, shelters are not conducive to exactly rehab. So rehabbing the dog in the shelter environment, can it be done? Sure. But the best chance of that dog staying alive is to get it out of the shelter. Next.
Daniel, thanks so much for the content you put out. When people ask how my dogs behave so well, I keep preaching about structure and rules.
Yeah.
Teaching the double down has helped my dogs so much around other dogs.
Yep, yep, yep. The double down is great. And who said that?
Daniel.
Daniel. And you know what, Daniel? And it's like, you're doing the work. You're applying the information. You're putting in the sessions, you're putting in the reps, but he's doing it for free. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. Next.
Kara, I want a career training dogs. I found a dog training place here in Cleveland that offers a school type setup for training people who want a career. They specialize in personal protection dogs. Thoughts?
In personal protection, first of all, I'm originally from Cleveland. So I left Cleveland in 1984. This is back when WMMS was the big radio station, home of the Buzzard. I don't know if they're still in business. So there's not a lot of money in personal protection dogs as a living. The pet dog business is where if you want to make a career out of. Now, does that mean you can't make a career out of in the PPD business? You can, but give it a shot. See how it goes. Next.
Gretchen, I kind of want a What Would Jeff Do pop socket, but everyone's going to ask me, where'd you get that What Would Jesus Do pop socket? Maybe I should wait till I move out. No, it says Jeff on it.
It says Jeff on it.
It's not what. It's not WWJD. It's What Would Jeff Do. That's all rubbed off. Mm.
Who's that? Our Gretchen?
Mm-hmm.
I'll send you one, Gretchen. I'll send you one, Gretchen, and I'll send you some stickers, too. And I'll send you a coffee mug. All right? So you have a coffee mug, pop socket, and stickers. All right? Give me your, message me your address. All right, message me your address.
Lisa, that's awesome advice. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Kyle, funny thing happened to me this week. I'm on a German Shepherd forum. Seen a post about a German Shepherd resource guarding, growling, and snapping at the owners when they try to remove him from the sofa. Tried to give what advice I had to give and recommended, obviously, a trainer, but a shock collar.
Mm-hmm.
I was told the forum doesn't even recommend as much as a stern no.
Wow. So, first of all, get off that fucking forum. So, this is what's wrong with... This is why we're fucked. This is why we're really fucked. A German Shepherd forum.
Mm-hmm.
A dog that is genetically designed to defend, to bite, to defend, to be wary of strangers, that is highly athletic, with a powerful mouth, that is used in military situations, mm-hmm. police situations, to track down, find, and apprehend. And this fucking forum is against the concept of saying no to a dog. All you people on that forum, you're fucked. You're literally fucked. Any advice you get on that, I shouldn't say any advice. I'm sure there's dribbles and drabbles of good advice, but not for stopping unwanted behaviors.
No.
So this is what they're going to recommend. You ready? Dogs on the couch. Take a bunch of high-value treats and throw them on the ground. Guess what? Dog comes off the couch. You know what you're actually training your dog to do? Get back up. Literally, get on the couch more. Let's see. Let me figure out this positive reinforcement thing. If I get on the couch, which is a behavior, and all of a sudden food shows up, which is a reward, I think I'll do that more.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Isn't it?
But if I get on the couch and I hear the word off and someone says, or no, and then I feel something uncomfortable, maybe I'll stay off that couch.
Makes sense to me.
Huh. Interesting. Yep. With that, we're closing out the show. So.
With that, we thank you.
We thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
What's that from? And for that, we thank you. That's from something.
Is it?
Where's it from, guys?
Serpentine.
I told Angelo to do that the other day when you were like whizzing balls at right. us. I'm like, Angelo, serpentine. He's like, ah! He's got like PTSD from those damn chunk of balls. I do too.
I nailed him today. That's right outside.
So sad.
He loves it. He thinks it's the funniest game in the book. Okay, I hit him in the leg today.
Shit on me.
Yep. So, all right, guys. I think
we've got a $4.99 top chat. You want to answer?
You got to answer it. Yeah. And then we got
to
go.
Alyssa, suggestions for dogs still trying to afford to head on the walk: snug, Herm's prong, corrected strong, not to nag. Use e-collar too. Worried of hurting his neck.
Okay, you're gonna do leash. Spatial pressure exercises. We're gonna make a video on that this week. All right, it's definitely gonna get made this week. Spatial exercises. Also, do my 180. Look up on my YouTube channel my 180. Not just a quick turn. It's a pretty invasive move, but it works. All right. Madly in love with you guys. Thank you all so much. I really appreciate all of you. Remember, if you have not checked out Angelo's Instagram page on Instagram at Angelo Gellman, Angelo Gellman on Instagram, give the kid some fucking follows. He's the one that's here every day. He actually was working today, working with an aggressive. He worked today. He helped proof today on his stories today. You'll see him actually on a scooter going around in circles around a dog that used to lunge at kids. So, kid fucking got fed. We gave him dinner. Gave him dinner.
Yeah.
He got macaroni and cheese, tomatoes, grapes.
Yeah.
And water, and probably carrots or something. All right. Madly in love with you.
Good night.
Good night, everyone. Good night, all. Love you all.